Good afternoon and welcome to the channel, guys. I have a fantastic topic I want to talk about today. I'm headed to the dealership to pick up my transmission filter, gasket, and glow plug, as I've got two more videos coming out on Mad Max in the next couple days, and I got to prepare for the YouTube call out. But first, gonna fire up the Duramax. Guys heard how loud that was. It just, say, got quiet. That is with the resonator delete. Not every time. I guess it depends on temperature and humidity, but that was the loudest cold start I've ever had on the Duramax. Deleting the resonator not only does that, but it increases the volume of the turbo whistle, which is fantastic. Let's get out of here. In my previous videos, I talked about the Ram Rebel TRX and the TR, and I explained how there was going to be a 426 engine 7.0, which would produce roughly, I estimated, if you go back and watch that video, I estimated between 525 horsepower and 550. It looks like it was leaked at 520, so I was off by 5 horsepower. I guessed it would be in the 525 range minimum, but they went with 520. We're not sure if that's 100%, but it looks like it's gonna be 520 horsepower. They've codenamed it the Banshee. Another thing that's super exciting that I am pumped about is the fact that in this information that was leaked on the Rebel TR, they also leaked information that the Rebel TR was gonna be for off-road and the TRX was gonna be more focused for street, since it has 707 horsepower. Even though that's not confirmed, it's gonna have the Hellcat engine, so most likely in the mid to high sixes. When you look at it like that, you really don't need that much power for off-road, so it looks like what Ram is doing is they're going to have the Rebel TR for off-road and the TRX is going to be the street truck. And if you've watched any of my previous videos, you would see I released a video on the Ram Hellcat 1500, and that is what this is starting to look like, considering the TR and TRX are on a 1500 frame and not a 2500, at least that's what it's looking like. The Rebel TR is going to have a 2.5-inch suspension lift. I believe it was 3-inch track width. Don't quote me, I'm 90% sure on that. It's also going to have an upgraded frame. That's what they said about the TRX. Upgraded frame, increased track width, and a 2.5 suspension increase in height. And I'm going to be assuming that they're comparing this with the Ram Rebel. Now, the current Ram Rebel produces 395 horsepower, 410 foot-pound of torque, and that is with the 5.7 liter. This is going to go up to 520 horsepower. So this is going to be a big jump for the off-road community that loves the Ram Rebel. But what I'm most excited about is the fact that the information that was leaked clearly states that the Rebel TRX is going to be focused on the street and the TR is off-road, which means we could be looking at a 707 horsepower street truck, which goes back to my original video. If you go watch that, it's back in March and it's Ram Hellcat 1500 leaked. Go watch that video. I predicted that the Ram Rebel TR would get the 426 Hemi, which would be a 7.0 liter with 525 horsepower. It's actually 520. They codenamed it the Banshee. And then I also said that there's going to be a Ram Hellcat 1500, which could focus on the Hellcat engine. And that is exactly what Ram is doing, because that's the information that was leaked. So I'm not sitting here just trying to, you know, pat myself on the back. I'm just trying to tell you guys that the information that I get is pretty accurate. So when I told you guys about that information in the video, it was pretty damn accurate. And now, with that being said, Ford is competing by putting the 7-liter 427 in the Raptor, which is basically an alternate version of the 7.3-liter, which they're putting in the F-250, the Super Duties and stuff. So I believe there's going to be a very big head-to-head competition between Ford and Ram, because of the fact that Ford has discontinued all their cars. They're concentrating on hybrids, crossovers, SUVs, and trucks. I think this is going to be an all-out war, but we're going to see. The only thing we really have leaked and somewhat confirmed is the TR and TRX, which I am super excited about. In fact, I'm more excited for the TRX if it's focused on the street. We really need a 1500 Ram on the street with big power like the TRX, and that's what they need to focus on, because in my opinion, that truck will be 10 times better than the Raptor. Now, I'm not someone who hates on the Raptor. I don't dislike that truck. I absolutely love it. I just like the old 6.2 better, even though it was underpowered compared to the EcoBoost engine. I just feel deep down that the Ram has a better interior. In my opinion, the interior of the Ram is just almost untouchable, especially the Longhorn version with the upgraded 10-inch screen is absolutely fantastic. SRT Mush's truck
Nomad's better than any Ford, if you ask me. But I do like the F-250, and the interiors are nice. I just think Ram is a little bit ahead of Ford in that department. And to be able to have that interior with a 700 horsepower engine, an upgraded frame in a street truck, in my opinion, Ram would dominate the Raptor. And it wouldn't matter what the Ford enthusiast would say, oh, the Raptor's better in off-roading than the TRX. Yeah, granted, it probably would be, considering the TRX is for the street only. However, you've got the TR, which in my opinion is going to be better than the Raptor because it's already producing 70 more horsepower versus the Ford Raptor at 450. And then you can also increase the power on that truck by adding a supercharger or turbo, and many guys are going to do that, and we all know it. So at the end of the day, Ram's decision to separate these two trucks into a TR and TRX, make one for the street and one off-road, is absolutely genius. You can't have a better idea than that, to give us two different trucks for two different purposes, because then they're going to be focused. Instead of being an all-rounder, it's going to be focused on doing certain things. If you want to go fast in the street, it's the TRX. If you want to go off-road, it's the TR. Both better than the Raptor, because the TRX is going to be faster on the street and the TR is going to be better in the off-road based on the specs. So I just can't wait to see these trucks in action. They're supposed to be coming out in 2021. Some of these leaks have said 2020, but I would say at the New York Auto Show in February of 2019, we're going to get more solid information. And I would say almost for certainty this time next year, we're going to start hearing more stuff on how you can pre-order them, just like it did with the Durango, which happened in September of 2017. So I would say by this time next year, you're going to hear more information on the bank pre-orders. I would say January of 2020 is when we're really going to start hearing the finalized numbers and everything like that. Unless, of course, Ram slips us a little surprise and the truck is available for pre-order this time next year. But I'm thinking it's probably going to be about a year and a half before the bank orders open. But I say mid-2020, spring of 2020 is where we're going to really be able to pre-order these trucks. But what do you guys think? I think this is very exciting. Sorry about the short video. I just really wanted to touch base on the Ram Rebel TR and TRX. And I told you guys there was going to be a Ram Hellcat 1500. That's basically what the TRX is. I'm super pumped and excited. Thank you to Dodge and Ram for giving us these awesome vehicles and awesome trucks. I am super pumped. Are you guys super pumped? I cannot wait for the New York Auto Show. This is going to be spectacular. I just might have to trade the Hellcat in for the TRX. That's a long time coming, and I've got multiple plans between now and then. There's going to be a lot of new stuff coming to the channel in the spring, so stay tuned for all of that. Got many videos coming out this week, and then, of course, the YouTube call-out is coming on Saturday. That is going to be fantastic, so stay tuned for all those videos. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment below. What do you guys think of the Ram Rebel TR and TRX? I think it's absolutely phenomenal. Don't forget, guys, support the channel at drivewithdemons.com. Get your hoodies there for the winter, t-shirts and key tags that say Mopar No Car. You flip them over, and they say Driveway Demons. For all my returning subscribers, thanks so much for watching all my videos. Don't forget, thumbs up, share. But until the next video.